everybody. Our next guest is a cookbook author. She's a baker. She's a blogger. And today she is here in our kitchen showing us how to make the most beautiful bronze pavlova. Please welcome to our home for the very first time, Melissa Coleman. Are very beautiful, but they're also, they're like gentle desserts.
Yes, they are gentle.
You know what I mean?
Yes, they're gentle. They're known for being quite finicky.
Yes,
but I've simplified this recipe for the home kitchen to make it so doable because it's so delicious. Everybody needs to make this bronze pavlova.
Right, but people are afraid to make them because for people at home who may not know what pavlova is, it's just basically meringue.
It's a baked meringue.
Yeah, that's it.
It's baked egg whites.
Right, and baked egg whites can be finicky.
Mark could do it, the way she said that. It's just
You could.
You could. You could. Melissa's going to show us how.
Yes.
Okay. So you guys dig in. So, by the way, what you're eating is for a serving of four. I just want everyone to know.
Yeah.
No, it's a serving of one.
Extra, extra large.
I mean, that's enormous.
Like, that's a whole cake. It makes two cakes, and you guys have a whole cake.
So all right. So it starts with our egg whites and our sugar that we've beat to stiff peaks.
Yes, we beat to stiff peaks, and then we're going to add in our vanilla.
Okay. Should we get this going again?
Yeah, let's get this going.
Okay, there you go.
We're going to add in our vanilla. And then I have a secret ingredient. This clear jar is vinegar.
Vinegar, interesting.
Yes. Vinegar is going to do two things. It's going to help cut the sweetness, so this isn't quite as sweet. It's also going to help stabilize the meringue.
Okay.
We have a little cornstarch in here, too, that's also going to help us. It's double foolproof.
Okay, that's nice.
I'm going to add this in.
There you go. Double foolproof. Did you hear that, Mark?
Double foolproof.
He wasn't listening. So right, how long will we then have to continue to beat this?
We're going to beat this until it's thick and glossy and holds stiff peaks.
Okay, so crank that up a little bit. While this goes, tell us about what you did on this parchment paper.
Yeah, so we have our parchment paper, and you'll see we have two cakes. We've got 2 6-inch circles. And then you want to flip it over so that you don't get lead in your
pavlova.
Yes.
So you're basically, you have the other way. There we go.
Yep, there we go.
You did that so you have a perfect serving.
Right, right. Because it is finicky, I'm helping myself out every way possible.
Okay.
All right. Now. So look at that. It's a nice,
that's a
stiff peak. It's not going anywhere.
That's beautiful.
All right.
If I didn't have a mixer, could I still do that?
If you're really strong.
You're a firefighter.
You'll be there for a long time.
It's an all day workout. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want to use a metal bowl if you're going to do that. You're going to be there forever. Yeah.
But I could do it.
You could do it. Well, yeah. Why a metal bowl,
Deb?
I don't know why. Right. Something about the way it
conducts. It evolves.
Yeah, exactly. It's science.
Copper
bowls.
It's science and stuff.
They told me to only use a metal bowl if I do it, so that's what I do.
But so, as sweet's involved with this, she can do it, trust me.
Okay, there you go. Mm-hmm.
This is whipped to stiff peaks.
Yes.
If it collapses when you fold it, then you need to keep whipping.
All right. So you're using this ice cream scoop. Is there a reason?
I love this ice cream scoop. It's actually a measuring utensil, and then it has a scooping mechanism, so everything comes right out.
Okay.
And you can evenly divide. So we're just going to...
And then just
spread
it out.
Melissa, are you sure this isn't a single serving?
It is now. I'm already in half of mine.
So. It's open to interpretation.
No, but you can make this ahead of time, can't you?
You can. If you want to turn into a grandma like me or my grandma, you can make this 2 months in advance in the freezer.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
What?
Yes.
And it doesn't get hard? Like, too hard?
No, because it's kind of hard now, and then it will reconstitute.
It's like a chewy,
like a marshmallow. Yeah. It's a marshmallow. It's
so
a baked marshmallow.
So do you put it in the freezer at this stage, or once you bake it?
We bake it off.
Oh, yeah, we have to bake it first.
Bake it off. So it's like a now and later. Like if you're serving a small group, you've got one for now and one for later.
Okay. So what makes it bronze? Or am I jumping on?
Yes, that's a great question. It's got brown sugar in the recipe, and the brown sugar helps to bronze it. It also makes it taste caramely and not quite so sweet.
Okay, so we pop this in the oven.
Let's pop this in the oven.
At what temperature for how long?
This is 275 degrees for 1 hour and 15
minutes. Oh, gosh, that's beautiful. Wow. That's really beautiful. And truly, if it cracks, it doesn't matter because you're going to cover it up.
Right, it's a really rustic dessert. I like rustic desserts because it makes me feel better when I make a mistake.
Right, exactly.
If when. So we've got these.
Just
we're
like
going to top them with whipped cream. And then we've got a delicious fruit salad. You can change this up as the seasons change.
Any kind of fruit on it?
Any kind of fruit.
But today we're doing pineapple and kiwi?
Yes, you want to make sure the fruit will macerate. When you add sugar, it will release juices.
Okay.
The juices are going to take this pavlova to a melt-in-your-mouth situation.
Oh. Yeah. There you go. So we put that on top.
Delicious,
Could you add, say... I'm asking for a friend, but could you put, like, say, peanut M&M's on it?
Yes, his friend would like to know.
Yes, right.
Reese's Pieces.
That's
if,
right.
If you're looking for a crunchy edition. Yes, absolutely.
This is just one of the beautiful recipes that you have in your new cookbook, The Minimalist Kitchen.
Yes.
I'd love to show our viewers some of the other ones. So basically, this is your book is The Practical Art of Making More with Less, which we will get into in just a moment. But what is that?
Those rolls you can make the night before, and then there's magic to them. You just stick them straight in the oven in the morning, and you don't have to wake up early.
There you go.
Yes, there's magic in that recipe.
Exactly. What is that?
This is a caramelized onion pizza. It's a little bit sweet. There's like a rosemary cream sauce. It's sweet from the caramelized onions. It's savory, sweet, so delicious. It tastes like Friday night.
Tastes like Friday night. I like that. Does that taste like Saturday night? What are we looking at?
This tastes like spring. This is a spring white wine pasta. It's also sweet, salty, peppery from the arugula.
That's beautiful.
Yes, thank you.
These almost look too pretty to eat, I feel like.
No, that's not true. That's not true at all.
Not true.
Just for a second, everybody thinks you're the coolest because this is so simple.
It is so simple.
It's beautiful, too.
Yes.
Yes.
I mean, I don't...
And zero
calories.
Can we
calories.
Pick it up?
I know.
We
do.
Well, you can.
Yes, zero calories.
Pick it up. It's so sturdy.
Well, only at the counter.
It's light as air. It must be.
And by the way, you know this dessert is named after a Russian ballerina.
Yeah, Anna Pavlova.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
Because she was so light on her feet.
That's right.
Yeah.
Wow.
Orly just
enjoy it.
Work at me.
You guys.